Hi, everybody. So we're going to go over something that's a little on the short side here. It's something called line notation. Whoops, sorry about that. It's line notation. And what it's going to allow us to do is it's going to allow us to take much of the information that would be in a picture of a galvanic cell and reduce it down into something that can be written on one line, thus line notation. The basic idea of line notation is shown here on the board. You always write the anode materials first, so anode is on the far left, and then the cathode stuff is on the far right. And then we use lines. This double line here denotes the, I guess you could kind of think of it as the salt bridge, right? It's the pathway that gets us from the anode compartment to the cathode compartment. So we use a double vertical line to separate one compartment from the other. We use single vertical lines to denote phase boundaries. So maybe where the solid anode, right, that piece of metal that's sticking in the solution, is in contact with the solution materials that would be in the anode. So we're going to follow this basic setup of anode then cathode and the use of the lines for a couple of specific examples. So let me get this guy out of our way. And let's take a look at this first specific example here that's a little bit on the simpler side. There we go. So what we have here is we have aluminum 3 turning into elemental aluminum and elemental magnesium turning into magnesium 2. So our oxidation, if you can, you know, figure this out by yourself, which you should be able to, right? This is magnesium 0 to magnesium 2. There's our oxidation. So that's what we're going to write in the anode compartment. So my anode has to be made out of magnesium. So I'm going to have solid magnesium that'll be in physical contact with the solution of magnesium 2 that I have in the aqueous phase. And that's pretty much all I have in the solution phase in the anode compartment. In the next example, you'll see there's a whole bunch of other stuff going on in there, but this is a fairly straightforward example. Then I have a double vertical line to denote going from one side to the other in the galvanic cell, from the anode to the cathode. And then I have my cathode solution materials, which in this case is aluminum 3 in the aqueous phase. And that gets turned into elemental aluminum. Now, as we've talked about before a little bit, this aluminum electrode here doesn't need to be aluminum. It could be some inert material. But for now, for simplicity's sake, we'll actually go ahead and use an aluminum electrode. So this line notation tells me what's happening in the anode, what's happening in the cathode, tells me what the anode electrode is made out of, tells me what the cathode electrode is made out of. So that's line notation for a fairly straightforward and simple example. Let's look at one that's a little bit more complicated. So let me get these guys out of our way. All right, I'm going to take a look at this example here. All right, so here we have permanganate under acidic conditions reacting with ClO3- to give ClO4-, Mn2, and water. So our line notation here is going to be a little bit more involved. So my oxidation is the ClO3- going to ClO4-. But you notice I don't have any solid metal in the anode compartment, right? I don't take elemental magnesium and oxidize it, or elemental copper and oxidize it. I only have solution phase chemistry in the oxidation, so I need an electrode. And whenever we need an electrode and we'd like it not to interfere with our chemistry, something like platinum or gold is often a good choice. So I'm going to use a platinum electrode, solid platinum, single vertical line to denote that that electrode is now sitting in a solution. And in solution, I have the chlorate, the ClO4-, and I'm also going to have some acid in that compartment, H+. So the anode solution contains all of these components. Now, you don't really need to write the ClO4- in there because eventually it's formed. What you really need to write are the reactants, okay, which in this case would be the ClO3- and the H+. but including the ClO4 minus certainly would not be wrong, and I tend to do that. Then we have a double vertical line, and we're going to now go over to the cathode compartment. And in solution in the cathode compartment, I have the, and I'm going to just draw this on a different line for space reasons. You should write this all on one long line. I have my permanganate, MnO4 minus. I'm going to get lazy and drop the aqueous phase just to save a little space. And let's see, that turns into Mn plus 2. And I also have H plus in that cathode compartment. So you notice I'm using commas to separate out materials that are all in the same phase. Now, that cathode solution is then in physical contact with the cathode electrode. And again, I don't have in my overall reaction here any solid metal being indicated as being a product here. So once again, I have to choose a nice inert electrode, so something like platinum would make a fine choice. So in this line notation, and again, both halves of the line notation here really should be on one continuous line, I have my anode electrode, my anode materials in solution, over to the other compartment, my cathode solution materials, phase boundary to my cathode electrode. So much of what you would draw in a picture of a galvanic cell is shown here in this abbreviated format called line notation.